video lecture on environmental engineering 2. In the last video, we saw about the highlights of the subject and important question. As I told you in the last video, the septic tank is a very important question. We are going to today's topic is septic tank. We are going to see the theory part as well as the problem part. Both they can ask. Most importantly, they will ask the problem. We will see one by one. We will see the construction working principle of septic tank. So septic tank, as we know, is an on-site sanitation process. So it is used for on-site sanitation. So what is on-site sanitation is the source of generation of sewage is the houses, the residential buildings. So the on-site, it is the process of the biodegrading the sewage happens at the site itself, that is on-site sanitation. So it is converted, decomposed in the site itself, that is on-site sanitation. The septic tank is used for that. As you know, septic tank is a rectangular tank. So we will see one by one the various parts. The first chamber is a rectangular chamber. First chamber, this is the inlet, this is the outlet of the septic tank. The raw sewage enters from this septic tank, from this outlet or inlet sewage, and it gets collected in this chamber. So in this chamber, sludge is formed. The clear supernatural liquid flows like this. There is a bathroom wall in between. So depth of the septic tank is 1.2 to 1.7 meter. So these are supernatural is collected, it goes via the outlet. So there is a sloped bottom complex. It is a brick wall all over the four sides. This is a plan, this is a section. So you see the plan view, the sewage enters this side, the bathroom wall, there is an opening in the bathroom wall through which the sewage flows or via the outlet. So this is the construction working principle of the septic tank. The working principle is anaerobic digestion process. So as far as this topic is concerned, we more focus on the problem part. Now let us see the problem part. Now let us see the question. Design the dimension of the septic tank for a small colony of 150 persons, provided with an assured water supply from the municipal headworks at the rate of 120 liters per person per day. Per person per day, 120 liters per person per day. Assume any data to be given. So, in the question, there is only two data given. 150 persons are there in the colony. For one person per day, this is per capita, the water supply is 120 liters. So water supply in the colony is 120 liters per person per day, per capita supply. 150 persons are there in the colony. This is the given data. We have to design the septic tank. So now we have to calculate the quantity of water supply will be. So, see, for one person per day, 120 liter is supplied. So, for 150 person, how much? 120 into 150. 150 point is the population. 120 is the per capita per day. Per person is per capita. Per capita per day. So, that will be 120 into 150 liters per day. That comes to 18,000 liters per day. So, now, you have to understand, the water supply is consumed by human beings for so many activities, drinking, washing, bathing. So all the water supply, 180,000 liters per day, is not converted to sewage. So we assume 80% of the water becomes sewage, converted to sewage. So amount of sewage, water sewage produces 14,000, 80% will be 14,400. Liters per day. So now you assume the detention time to be 24 hours. Detention time means what? Come to the diagram. See the diagram. So the inlet and the outlet. Time taken between the inlet and outlet. Time for which the sewage stays in the septic tank is your retention time. So retention time may be 24 hours. It takes 24 hours, it stays for 24 hours. The quantity of sewage produced during the retention is, see, for one day, 14,400 liters per day means, for 1 hour, 14,400 divided by 24 into 24. It takes for one day, stays for one day. Hence, 14,400 liters, that will be the quantity of sewage produced. Now, the rate of deposited sludge, this is assumed 30 liters per capita per day. Sludge produced is 30 liters per capita per year. Sorry. Assuming the time period of cleaning and year. Every only clean the septic tank. That is what we assume. That means sludge deposit. Septic tank is made up of two things. Sewage and the sludge. We have to accommodate the sewage and the sludge. So we have to calculate the quantity of sewage. We have to calculate the quantity of sludge. Both we have to add, that will become the volume of the septic tank. That is the problem. So volume of sludge deposit will be 30 liters into 150 for 1% per 1 year. 150% is this much into 1 year for 1 year. This is 4,500 liters of sludge. So total capacity will be sewage, quantity of sewage produced plus 4,400 sludge. Sewage plus sludge. That it will give you 80,000 liters. So we have to have a volume 18.9 cubic meter is the volume of sewage and sludge together produced. So we have to have a septic tank which accommodates 18.9 cubic meter. Volume of septic tank should be 18.9 cubic meter. So surface area of the tank is, we assume a depth 1.5 meter depth. So the volume is 18.9 divided by depth will be the surface area, 12.6 meter square. Ratio of the length will be, we assume as 3:1. Length will be 3:1. We get breadth as 2.05 meter, say 2.1 meter. So length we get 6 meter. So area of the cross section provided is 12.6 meter, which is same as the required, so it is satisfied. So dimension of the septic tank will be 6 meter by 2.1, by here we have 3.3 meter, so that will be 6.6 meter by 2.1 meter by 1.8 meter. Length is 6 meter, breadth is 2.1 meter, depth is 4.3 meter. This is the septic tank design. Design the septic tank. So hope you have understood the construction working principle and the septic tank design. So this is a very important question. Kindly understand the concept and practice the problem. Thank you very much for viewing this video. Please like, share, and subscribe to the channel. Thank you.